So let me ask you, have you ever forgotten something? Maybe it was an event or a date or something that you're supposed to do, and for whatever reason, you had it in your mind, and then when the time came, you simply forgot all about it. I know I do that a lot. In fact, I have to keep a to-do list, and I have to keep a track of things that are happening on my calendar, because sometimes I just forget. And it's not that I'm a forgetful person, it's just that sometimes life around me gets busy. Maybe things at the church get a little crazy and a little busy one week versus another, and sometimes I just forget. And so there are ways that we can remember to do things. And so one of those ways is to write things down. And so each week I put together a to-do list of things that need to get done that week so that I don't forget anything. And also on my calendar. Because as a family, we have so much going on as a family, we make sure that the important things get on the calendar, because if they're on the calendar, that reminds us that they have to happen. And so we live by to-do lists and calendars. But I know if I'm forgetting stuff, you've probably forgotten stuff too. Maybe it was a homework assignment that you got caught up in, you know, a favorite TV show, or you were binging something, or you were on your device with somebody or playing a game, and now it's like 9 o'clock at night and you're like, oh, I forgot to do this thing, it's due tomorrow. Or maybe there's a test that was coming up and you forgot to study for it, and now the test is here and you're thinking, oh my gosh, I completely forgot to study for this test. The thing is, we all forget things, and there's ways for us to remember. I write things down, but maybe you've practiced another way of trying to remember stuff. Have you ever tried to remember things to a song? Like, we would have done this when we were little. I know I remember learning the alphabet to the alphabet song. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, P. Now you get the picture for that, right? We learn things a little bit with songs. So I remember as a little kid being taught that song. And I remember when our kids were little, we taught them that song. But we also taught them songs like Old MacDonald. Remember Old MacDonald? Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on that farm he had a, and someone would shout out an animal. E-I-E-I-O, so let's say pig. And on that farm he had a pig, and then they would get to the pig and there was a oink oink here and an oink oink there. And it was a silly song, but it helped you learn animals and what they sounded like. And so sometimes music or songs can help us remember things. Sometimes they're silly little things, sometimes they're important things. Like, I remember even in Sunday school, learning the books of the Bible to a song, or learning a Bible verse to a song. Well, that's a great way for us to learn and remember things. But these devices, these memory tools, aren't just for remembering silly things like, you know, what sound an animal makes, or learning the alphabet. These are actually really good tools for helping us remember really important things as well. In fact, this month we've been in this series called Anthem, where we've been looking at the book of Psalms and trying to understand a little bit more about what worship looks like, and who God is, and how we can worship God a little better. But the Psalms is actually a book of songs. They were various songs, they were rhymes, there were some rhythms. But these were things that were written by the Israelites to help them remember. So we now live in a culture that does a lot of its storytelling through media, whether it's social media like Instagram or Twitter or Facebook. Or maybe it's a national media program, like maybe the news, whether it's Fox, CBS, NBC, CNN, there's a whole bunch of them out there. We now tell stories a little different, but we still tell them. And we tell them by giving people what's happening in and around their communities and even around the world. Well, this isn't something that we've created. This is something that actually goes way back, and it goes way back even to the Israelites. In fact, if we were to go back to the time when the newspaper was the big thing, it was all about the headlines. And the way that they would kind of go through and sell or pass out the newspapers was they would to, you know, shout out the headline. Whatever the big news is, or the big story for the day, it would be the front page, the big headline across, and they would yell it out and encourage people to come and read the story. So let's imagine if that was like something that the Israelites practiced. What if the Israelites told the happenings that they were experiencing through major headlines? Let's see if you might recognize some of these. Ready? Here's an Israelite headline. Israel on the run. After years of enslavement, late last night, the Israelites fled the nation of Egypt under the protection of their God. Now, you probably know that story, and so you can kind of imagine what was happening in that story. But that's a pretty grabbing headline, isn't it? Israel on the run. How about this one? Cloudy with a chance of quail. Pretty good headline there. Let's see. Eyewitness accounts say food is falling from the sky. Flocks of birds and a mysterious bread-like substance have appeared in the desert just in time to save the Israelites from starvation. Now, do you know that story? That's the story of when God provided food for the Israelites through quail and through manna. But it's a pretty good headline, right? It grabs our attention pretty quick. How about one more? Israel undefeated. Yet after another confrontation with enemy armies, Israel remains undefeated in battle due to mysterious and miraculous circumstances. And again, another great headline, but it reminds us of the stories of the Israelites and how they defeated their enemies with God's help. You see, one of the great ways for us to remember things is not just through song, but through story. But what if you had a story that was put to a song? Well, that's what some of the Psalms are. They are stories that are put to song. In fact, what we're going to do tonight is you're going to take some time as a small group to look at some chapters in the Book of Psalms that are very short, but they tell the story of the things that God did for them. And as you look at these stories, these headlines right here in Psalms, you're going to try to find the pattern that shows up in each one. And so I'm not going to give anything away. I'm going to actually have you guys do this in just a few seconds. But I want us to be thinking about what it looks like for us to remember. To remember the good things that God has done for us. But I want to challenge you guys, as you go through these verses, these chapters in Psalms, I want you to look for the patterns and kind of see how the Israelites used their Psalms to remember the good things that God has done for them. And that was their way of worshiping God, because as they remembered the good things that God did, their attention was turned back to Him, and they worshiped Him. They were reminded of His love for them, and they were reminded of their gratefulness for what He has done. And that can be very, very true of us. When we go back and we remember the good things that God has done, it reminds us of God's love for us. And it also hopefully reminds us of how we should be responding towards God. So tonight, with your small groups, go through these chapters in the Psalm. And as you do, find the patterns. Listen to the story that the Israelites are sharing. And try to imagine what it might have been like for the Israelites to be reminded of God's faithfulness as they sang through these stories. And then later tonight, talk about what it might look like for you to start thinking through how you might capture and remember the things that God is doing in your life, so that one day you can look back and you can be reminded of God's goodness, His faithfulness, and His love in your life. And it'll cause you to worship Him just a little bit different. All right, guys, have a great night in your small groups, and I'll see you next week.